this morning. It's so good to see you all on this rededication for the Wall of Fame for Steve and Cassie Gaines. My name is Judy Macklin Snodderly. I was in class of 66, a very good friend of Cassie's and Steve's, I can say. Steve and I shared a birthday. We also went to Team Lock together back in the early 60s. But I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everyone for coming and also recognize Bobby Gaines, or Bob Gaines, I should say. Steve Cassie's. So, who we all know. And is there anyone else here who is was a close friend of theirs or a relative that we don't know about that we could recognize? Okay, Richard Hawkins.
Second cousin.
Second cousin. Oh, I didn't know that, Richard. I've known you forever.
Sorry, who else? Chris
Gaines.
Oh, okay. Also a cousin.
Are you Damaris Gaines' daughter?
Yes.
Okay. Welcome.
Thank you.
And if I understand we have several band members here.
Oh, yeah.
Would you like to stand so we can recognize you, please?
I'll stand.
At our 10th class reunion, Cassie came back to that, and of course that was in 1976. And we could actually afford a band at that time for our class reunion. I'm not sure how we did that. But it was a band out of Joplin, it was called Solid Gold. And they were pretty good, they were country. And anyway, Cassie came, and so we asked the band if she could sing with them. And of course they were kind of like, one of those. And everything. So anyway, she did. She got up, she sang Proud Mary, and then she sang another song. And they just played. They just shut up and let her sing. It was amazing. Okay, let's get started. October 20th, 2017 marks the 40th year anniversary of the tragic plane crash that took the lives of Steve and Cassie Gaines. Returning from a show in Greenville, South Carolina, the Leonard Skinner Band's charter plane ran short of fuel and crashed in the Mississippi woods. In the crash, Ronnie Van Sant, guitarist Steve Gaines, backup singer Cassie Gaines, and road manager Dean Kilpatrick, along with the two pilots, lost their lives. We would like to share some pictures, video, and music before the award is unveiled.
67 went together to update the picture that was in the garden here, the Hall of Fame. And this is the picture that is has been replaced. And so we really do appreciate you all coming out to celebrate that with us. We're going to give anyone an opportunity if they wanted to, if they had a story about Steve and Cassie. Would you like me to tell us about that right quick? So, I would introduce you, but I can't remember your name. I know you're a band member.
Wow, what a great family this was. You know, Bud had the upstairs, but I got to play that. Just an absolutely wonderful family. It'd be nice to acknowledge a lot of the players. And we have to mention the Poole brothers. Thank you. Thank you. Sam Kedrick. Yes, we came from the Smooths. Just incredible people. Steve came over the house and recorded some songs at my house, and he had to borrow $5 for gas. And so he gave me his address. And I got a $5 bill. I'll check a $5 bill in the mail because it was that honest and that kind. God, there's been so many players, you know, just a ton. And the Ravens, I got to see the Ravens with John Burroughs, and they were wonderful. And the cellar door, I got to experience a lot of bands in Brazil. And I played with them in the Magic Kitchen. We opened up for the Strawberry Alarm Clock, and in the band was Ed King, who actually kicks off the band. Ed King has the same birthday as Steve Gaines, and September 14, 1949. We love Steve. I mean, the whole family. The whole family is wonderful. Bring some more people.
The night before Steve went to audition, he and John Moss came over to my house. I was playing in a group in Joplin. And Stephen and Johnny came over to the house. And Steve said, you know, Cassie's in the group and I'm going to go audition. And he said, do you think I can make it in that room? I said, Steve, are you kidding? Yeah, you're going to make it. You'll teach those boys something. You know, do it, man. Moose is here somewhere. Do you remember that, Moose?
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it. I thought, hell yes! Man, you're one of the greatest. Go for it. And sure enough, you know, the rest is history. I was so honored to play with Steve. When you play with Steve, your level of performance went up. It did. You couldn't help but play your best when you played with Steve. And I want to also thank all the guys that played with him, because of that, you know, every band that he played in was a good band. We did well, always, because we had Steve. But there's a lot of good guys that played with him, too. I was talking to Hot Pool about his brother, Dee. Dee was a great performer, too. A little guy that really came on strong. They could have done some things. Johnny Rose, great guitar player. John Moss, great guitar player. They're all over the place around here. This place has produced some great musicians.
Johnny Brooks.
Yeah, Brooksie. God. I could go on and on. Wonderful things has happened here in old Mudville. Carol Littleton. Richard Kellen. People that I met personally that I've been just honored. It's just a great place. I want to thank you all for having this event, because back then, you know, Steve wasn't thought of so much by the great powers of mind in Oklahoma. I remember the situation. I lived here. I remember what they went through. I remember the Baptist church and what they said about him. I remember all that stuff. You know, I'm not trying to bring up bad things, but it was a big fight. It was a big struggle. And finally, this man who's finally gets the recognition he deserves. I'm glad. Thank you.
So, thanks again for coming out. We really appreciate it.